It sucks. It sucks. Let me get the magic wand of sleep helping, okay? The magic blue glowy wand. And together, you and I will work through them, okay? So, as you know, I am an actual physician, and I have been suffering from nightmares myself for several years, related to some traumatic events that happened when I was taking care of patients, some very stressful things involving babies, okay? I was also a sexual assault medical forensic examiner for a year in Korea, where there are a very high number of sexual assaults in the military, okay? So, I have nightmares, and I get it, but I've had nightmares for a long time, okay? And I have some techniques that I'd like to share with you, okay? I'm so sorry. I know it's so scary and frustrating, and it's frustrating when they kind of control your life, right? And I have some techniques I would like to share with you, okay? So I have the magic blue wand, the feeling helping. Okay, look how it glows, isn't it pretty? And we're going to work through some stuff together, okay? My license number is in the description below. Secret sleepy place, not in the real world, and so I can't individualize anything to you for diagnosis or treatment of disease, and that's important. So, let's figure this out, okay? So this nightmare rehearsal therapy that I am going to go over with you is phenomenal. It works, it has an amazing cure rate for nightmares, okay? It's evidence-based. It was developed by, let me just check my facts here. It's an outgrowth of Stephen LaBerge's work with lucid dreaming. It's been done by tweaking Barry Krakow's imagery rehearsal therapy, EMDR elements from Francine Shapiro, Drs. Peyton Rivera and Donovan developed it. If you go to any idiot can figure this out, by the way, it's pretty easy. So you can go to PubMed and actually check. Nightmare reprocessing is actually what it's called. Nightmare reprocessing. Okay, I know you don't feel good. Poor you. I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. Psychological techniques are hard to study. Let's see what the American Academy of Sleep Medicine has. This scripting therapy may be used for the treatment of nightmare disorder. So if you want to read their whole position paper and look at the studies that they put behind it, you can go to practice guidelines, go to the Journal of Clinical Sleep Medicine, 2018. So, but my point being, this is evidence-based stuff. Unfortunately, the evidence that we can find on PubMed isn't as good as, like, you know, for a medication like prazosin, but this is recommended by the, based on studies that the American Academy of Sleep Medicine has found, and so we can try going through it together, okay? Alright, I'm so sorry you're feeling terrible. So for the first step, and this is something you can do on your own too, let me have you tell me about the nightmare. While you're telling it to me, just write it down. If you need more time. Yeah, absolutely. I'm listening. you're done writing it out, then we'll do this together, okay? Because I have the same, kind of situation. So once you're done writing it out, can you write down one negative assumption that this dream says about you? Survey the damage, walk past the foxhole with a soldier who this guy had to kill, and they say, wow, he really could have gotten us, and that makes him feel better about having had to kill that person, right? So it's very specific. I knew about another soldier who, because he had seen someone blow up right in front of him, and after that, what he would do is, at the end of his dream, after the explosion goes off, he just flew away to his cabin in Alaska and went fishing, and everything was safe and fine. It worked like a charm for both of these guys. For one of mine, I, sat down and had tea with the thing that I was scared of and told it that it was very small, and then it became very, very, very small and disappeared, and then I went and hung out with God. That was how I ended mine. So however you want to end it, that you know you'll be able to wake up peaceful. Yeah. Yeah, there's one that I need to work through currently. I don't know. It's really difficult to figure out what to tack onto the end, isn't it? Yeah, we gotta take some time to think it through. So here's your assignment for the next 3 weeks then. Uh-oh. Yeah, get ready. Write it down. Get ready to write it down. So once in the morning and once before bedtime, you gotta sit down and read the whole thing out to yourself. Everything that you've written, including the fixed ending. Okay. When you do it at bedtime, put on some calming music, something that you enjoy that relaxes you, help you get ready for bed. Maybe put on some tea. Whatever helps you calm down, okay? Like this one soldier in the example that I have saved in front of me, which I will link below so that you can use it. Yeah, link it below. Please download it because it'll help you remember how to do it. He doesn't have any use for guided imagery, so he does several minutes of his favorite classical music, right? Just put on something, makes you feel chilled out, and then read all the way through. Plus the positive and negative affirmations and the ending of the nightmare. Really memorize and think about the good ending that you've added. Okay. Read the positive assumption aloud to yourself. Okay. Say the positive assumption aloud. Then close by listening to 10 more minutes of your favorite, you know, music, or doing your guided imagery, doing your yoga, whatever it is you're gonna do. Okay. The whole thing doesn't take more than 20 minutes. Shortest mental health video I think ever, because it's really about you. It's really about you writing together. We can sit here and write together for a little bit. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that. Let's do our best and figure it out. Let me get my little pen and my little, where's my notebook? What has happened to my notebook? Are you using it as a pillow? I can't find my notebook. Did you steal it? I know you like to do that kind of stuff. It's the one that's got Princess Leia on it. That's mine. You can't have it. That's mine. Where is it? Steal it. It's here under your pillow. Look, just because we're in the same secret agent group and we use, like, our sleeping bags are next to each other and we are in the same tent, doesn't mean you can be stealing my Darth Vader notebook. You hussy. Alright, let's write together and then we can go over it and start to go to sleep. Makes you wake up after about 4 hours. We only have 4 hours of nighttime left anyway.